Hi friend, so before moving to next session of the HTML, we have to learn about something about that CSS. CSS is basically a cascaded style sheet which is going to use in HTML part. Without CSS, the HTML is incomplete. So before moving to the next part of the HTML, we have to learn more about that CSS. So CSS, full form of the CSS is cascaded. Style sheet. Let me increase my font. So basically any HTML part is incomplete before without this. So CSS will help the HTML to improve its pages and its appearance, and so cascaded style CSS is basically having three types of definition or declaration pattern in HTML. We can declare it CSS in three types. Basically the declaration of the CSS will be in three types. One, we can declare directly into inline, like if I am using any tag. Sorry, if I am writing any tag, so I can declare it inside this as well, or I can inline style sheet, and then it's internal and external. So inline means in between the tags, I can directly declare after opening the tag. I can declare at the inside the, like attributes as well. Internal means I am declaring in head or body section. Basically, we can declare the style sheet inside the two content, like one in head and other in body. Apart from this, we cannot declare. We can directly call it by using this external as well. So internal, we can directly declare it in head section or in body section. External, we can create in some other file, and by using some reference link, we can directly call it in our code. So we learn one by one in our session. So first, I am starting with that internal. I just written two tags, one for h1 and one for paragraph, and here in head section I have created a style sheet. You can see this style. Inside that body section or part of body, I have declared that the color of the body. Instead of declaring here as a bg color, I can declare it here, because when we are using in HTML pages, if we are creating lots of tags related with the attributes, so it will get complicated to making changes of the maintenance part is also well by using this. So we can directly declare in style in different page or different section, and we can directly call it here. Because when we are using the small case of CSS, so we can directly declare it internally. And if we are having lots of CSS case, like for every tag we are having different types of style, we can call it by externally. So let me So my body section contains the color of the background color. So instead of writing bg color, I am writing here background color as red. For h1 tag, the color of the tag is in green, and for paragraph, color of the tag is in yellow. So let me save this desktop. CSS internal. html save. Now let me run this, launching Chrome. Now you can see my tags is appearing, the background color is in almost right. Then this paragraph is in, this paragraph is in yellow color, and my headphone tag is appearing in green. So basically this is use of the internal style sheet. And if I don't want this tag into internal, then I am just putting as a comment. Here for multi-line comment we are using this style pattern. Like if I am putting a multi-line comment, so I have to just type this, and at the end I write it to like this. It will like this. Here there is a space in between two tags. Yeah, you can see this. This is my multi-line comment. And if I want to create as a single line comment, so I have to just put like this. This is single line comment. And like this. This, not like this, this. So you can see this is a single line comment. If I want to comment it my tag, so that will not appear, this tag is not appearing in my program. Let me run this. So you cannot see that the style sheet is appearing into, like let me refresh this page. Yeah, you can see the it's a simple code, so it is not affecting to my code. So internally if I want to declare as a style, style, color, is green, so not affecting. Let me check it is style in double quotes, style equal to basically. If you want to add this into inline, so we can directly use it here. Let me refresh my page. You can see this. So this is called as inline style sheet. Let me remove this as well. Now if I want to add this as a external CSS, so I just have to add one more CSS and save it into same tutorial external dot css. So this is extension name of this CSS file, external dot css. Whenever we are creating an external file for the CSS, we have to save as format CSS. So when I open this desktop, you can see my CSS file is appearing here, Cascaded style sheet. So my CSS file is created here. I just have to call my CSS file. Style closing of style style sheet, the name contains style sheet and type equal to text or CSS. Here we can provide it that style sheet reference, so external.css my file name, external.css, it's existing in same folder, otherwise we have to provide the name of the file. Let me check this first, the reference name which we are providing here, relation. We have to just put this as link relation style sheet and href external.css. So basically when we are declaring with this, so we have to just put this link as a link relation, article means relation, style sheet href in the location of the file. If that file is not containing in the same folder, we have to provide the full path of the information and then the name with extension name. So just see, we have to save this now, run it again. Now you can see this is the same tag. If you want to add multiple style sheet, so we can directly add it here. Like if we are having multiple tags, or like if I'm using paragraph on multiple section or something like this, I just have to, like if you are having a multiple style sheet, so we can call it here, like I am rechanging it to h1 to h2 and removing this paragraph section, copy then paste it to here, like h3, and creating one more style sheet this. I have to just copy this, h1, I'm changing from h2 to h3, in place of green I am using some other color blue, पर्पल एनी कलर येलो, सेव दिस सेम लोकेशन एक्सटर्नल टू डॉट सी एस एस I have to change the file name here, external 2.css. Now save this and refresh my page. Now you can see this in blue color the h2 tag and h6 tag. So if you are having multiple CSS file integrated in one HTML, we can directly put it here and call this. So basically when we are creating multiple web pages or different types of animation or different types of look and feel matter, so we are using multiple CSS file, and for different tags also we are using that. So that is a helpful rather than creating, means this is basically helpful while maintenance phase of the website. So rather than creating a complex web pages, if there's any error occur, so finding that it is very difficult to find it out in HTML page itself. So basically developers are linking their CSS file into HTML with the different pages. So hope you like it and understand this. If you have any comments or suggestion, please provide in comment box, and please do like subscribe for the updated tutorials. Thank you.